on Wednesday and listen to this quality review. I'm Craig.
I'm Sean.
He's getting better at this, isn't he?
He's really good.
Yeah, he's starting to like it. Yeah. Starting to like it. And on this week's show, we've got a few different things. We've got Social Deck by Soma, which is taking social media and card magic and fusing them together. We've got Suzanne, who's brought out her award-winning act live at the Magic Castle. And then finally, you've got, what's that one called?
Spontaneous Combustion.
Spontaneous Combustion, which is absolutely fantastic as well. But first of all, we're going to be looking at the Social Deck by Soma. Now, there's a lot of buzz about this online. And my first exposure to this was you telling me that you absolutely loved the trailer for this.
I love the trailer for it.
Yeah. What you have is you have a deck of playing cards, all in a social media box, and you've got a whole bunch of, we're going to get a couple of these off the sticks, but let me show you first of all what you kind of get. You get a whole bunch of gimmicked cards. Soma goes through how many different routines? 40 modern effects. Sorry, let me just show you this here. 40 modern effects, 16 fully explained routines.
Now, are you going to show us some things with them cards?
Should I get it off the sticks first of all, should I?
I think you need to get it off the sticks.
They're showing the back of the DVD. Yeah. You can't see it from here.
You're getting better at this reining me in thing, aren't you? Okay, yes, Dave, get it off the sticks. Thank you very much. So, yeah, you've got 16 different routines that are fully explained. You've got 40 different stuff.
You've got a whole bunch of...
Check this out. Come down and have a look at these cards. You've got a whole bunch of different cards, different gimmicks. That's to, like, take the logo and squash it and turn it into numbers. You got wild card-type things. You've got anniversary waltz-type things, you've got coin routines
and
stuff with birthdays,
and much more, not just what's in your hand.
But I've set those up for a trick.
I know you have, but I'm just saying there's loads. You get a whole pack full of
randomly
stuff.
Harry Houdini, happy birthday,
that's,
just loads of different
stuff.
That's
for the ambitious card trick,
that's for the ambitious card,
the metamorphosis,
the amazing sub trunk.
It's brilliant,
absolutely. But I'm going to go through a couple of routines. There's so many different ones, but these were a couple of my highlights. Sean,
yes, Craig,
I'm gonna show you a trick, buddy. I have a couple of, we'll call these prediction cards.
Okay.
I get to look at them, you don't. We're going to get back to those a little bit later on.
Excellent.
I also have a share button, because everybody knows with social media, it's all about sharing.
It is.
Now, I've got a whole bunch of profile pictures here. We've got male profiles and female profiles, loads of different profiles. One of the things with social media is you can upload photographs.
Yes, you can.
You press that button right there. That actually starts to upload my gallery to the cards.
Really?
Yeah, we wait a couple of seconds. One, two, three. And it's loading.
Okay.
It's taking a while. Hold your hand out for me. We should wait a couple of seconds. Let's see if we just wait a couple of seconds. Hopefully that's now uploaded, the gallery. Turn the card over. Let's have a look. Gallery is uploaded. Those are all of my favorite pictures that I have on my social media site. We've got a whole bunch. And right there, that's my sister's cat.
That's your sister's cat.
That's my sister's cat.
I've seen your sister's cat before.
You've seen my sister's cat.
Yeah.
Would you like to touch my sister's cat?
I've touched your sister's cat before.
I want you to touch it right here, live on the Wizard Product Review.
Here it goes.
There it goes. Boom. You know what that does?
What does it do, Craig?
Makes my sister's cat bigger. It actually pops it into view.
Really?
Look at that. There it is.
I like that. She's got a nice cat.
She has got a very nice cat. Ginger as well. Hold your hand out, though, for me.
Yeah.
We're going to go one step further. You see, this kind of has Instagram features in it as well.
Instagram?
You know, like with Instagram, you can kind of change the filter on a picture?
Yeah.
Watch, if I just take my sister's cat, I can do that, and I can actually give it a black and white filter.
Wow.
But the reason I want you to hold your hand out is
okay.
Because I actually prefer it in color, not black and white.
Okay.
So if I just do that, turn it over, it's back to Ginger.
Wow.
It's pretty cool, huh?
I like that.
We're going to go one step further. See, we're going to take the share button, you know, the share button. It's been down there from the very, very beginning, right? This is what we're going to do. I want you to watch the share button.
Okay? Yeah.
We're going to put the share button down there.
And I'm going to share your sister's cat?
We're going to share my sister's cat with the whole world.
Okay.
Okay? Watch this. All I have to do is do this and flick. And there, my sister's cat is shared with every single person in the world. Boom.
That's excellent.
Isn't that great?
It is.
That's pretty good.
I love it.
We're going to go one step further.
What?
Yeah, we're just going to get rid of my sister's cat.
Okay.
We'll put it over there. We don't need that anymore. Mm-hmm. And like I said, all these other cards, they're all like male and female profiles.
They are.
All the way through. I'm going to get you to shuffle these cards. I don't want you to think that I have them in a particular order or anything like that. So what I want you to do, first of all, is take these cards and give them a shuffle. Mix them up. Make sure they're all mixed up.
Mixy, 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 mix. Yeah, mix.
And then put them there.
Yeah.
And then give these a shuffle.
Well, that's fair, yeah. Mix, 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 mix.
And put those there.
Put them on top of there?
Yeah.
Like this?
Why not? Yeah, perfect. That's fair, right?
Yeah.
Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to deal cards like this onto the table.
Mm-hmm.
And as I deal cards, just say stop anytime you want.
Okay. Stop.
Do you want one more on there?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
You just
does
want
it
those
affect ones? The trick?
No, it doesn't really. It's not important. We'll get rid of all of these. These are the only ones that matter, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, do you remember I put right at the very beginning two predictions down on there?
You did.
I tried to predict how many friend requests you would have today. Because the thing is, I know you're a popular guy. Everybody loves you.
Yeah, you know.
And you're the star. There was a product of you. So I thought you'd have lots and lots of friends requests. So I went for 12.
12?
Take the cards, keep them face down, count them onto the table one at a time.
Well, I could have said stop anywhere.
You could have said stop anywhere, yeah.
So I've decided how many cards are
exactly.
Here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12.
Right.
That's good. That's
but,
great.
But I made another prediction. You see, I predicted that there'd be two girls that want to be friends with you and 10 guys. I thought there'd be more guys than girls because you appeal a lot to magicians. Magicians are guys, very few female magicians.
It's disappointing.
Yeah, but let's see. Turn them face up. And
one at a time, or
turn them into two piles. If there's a girl, but turn them face up.
Yeah.
And then guys there, girls there. So we've got
okay, guys.
One guy, two guys, three, four, five. Oh, there's a girl. Five.
Wow.
Six, seven, eight, nine, 10.
So 10 men and two girls.
Proof positive that I am the king of social media.
You've spot on. I love it.
There you go.
It's great.
That's just a couple of simple things with it. But the point is, with this deck, is Soma gives you a few different ideas. There's some nice stuff like taking a male and a female profile and bringing them together into one. He's got stuff that revolves around birthdays. He's got wild card routines.
Can we get
there.
All the cards back up?
Yeah, do you want to have a look at some of them?
Just and the ones down here. Just
actually,
so people,
they're just profiles, really, to be honest.
Yeah, but I just... But you can still do stuff with them. Like,
yeah,
you just
can.
Did a routine then. There's all these cards, all those cards. It does come with instructions. It comes with a DVD teaching you how to do different things with money and all sorts of things with all these different cards. But what's great about them, from my point of view, is you can use your own creativity to come up with your own stuff.
Yes.
And
that's what you're most excited
yeah,
about.
Yeah, and what's really nice about it is, for us as magicians, we go, oh yeah, it's just a load of packet tricks put together. But from a layperson's point of view, if you're going up to somebody's table, say, in a restaurant, then this is really different to a card trick.
Yeah.
This is something that's going to grab their attention.
Well, you would know, because obviously you were involved in profiles.
Yes. And these... These are really, they're incredibly well-made cards. You can do stuff with them. Like, you were doing slides with them. They
yep.
work. They're easy. They're nice cards. I love it. I like it.
It's great. Yeah, the pitch on this, on the trailer, is you don't have to do card tricks anymore. Now you can make card tricks relevant. I disagree with that, because I think that card tricks are always great. You know,
absolutely.
You know, it's not like you need to make them relevant. A pack of cards is a pack of cards. What I think is good about this is, if you're the sort of guy that just does card routines, well, you can do a couple of card things, and then you can take this away and take this out, and it's more relevant.
Well,
it is a relevant thing
to one set of spectators. You do one trick.
Yeah.
Yeah. What would you give it?
Well, Soma talks about setting the deck up and having a mm-hmm. series of three or four tricks that he does with the deck that resets itself at the end,
yeah.
which is great for restaurant workers or people that need to perform over and over again. I really like this. I'm going to start playing around with some of these. I want to come up with my own ideas with it. The DVD is very well shot. Everything's great about it. I'm going to give this 95%, and I know we both agreed on this. We're going to give it Worker of the Week as well.
Yeah, Worker of the Week, 93% from me.
93%. Now, here's the worker. At Blackpool, you bought out profiles. Why don't you tell everyone about profiles? Because I know you love it. I know you use it all the time.
Profiles is it's a mentalism type routine. It's like remember a night out with the girls.
Yeah.
That's the
which
main.
It's a great trick.
That's the main effect. So basically, there's different Facebook profile cards. And one of them, well, you show that they're all these pretty girls.
Yeah.
Somebody chooses one that they want to go on a date with. They
yep.
turn over the card that they've chosen.
It's a
and it happens to be the Dot Cotton lookalike.
Yeah.
Okay? She's lovely. I'm sure I've dated her before.
I know you've put a whole bunch
of
different
stuff
in there.
There's a whole bunch.
Yeah.
There's several different
but
tricks
to be honest,
you can do with the cards.
I think for a bar crowd,
yeah.
if you're in a bar and somebody goes, hey, show us something. These are made so they fit in your wallet. One night out with the girls is brilliant.
It is.
You do that, and it makes it more relevant. So we're going to give this away for free. Anybody that orders the Social Deck by Soma between now and midnight on Friday, you're going to get shipped absolutely free of charge profiles in with your order. Absolutely free. Guys, it's a really good product. I know there's going to be creative people out there that love it and use it. And now, if you want to get it, you're going to get profiles free between now and Friday midnight. Okay, next up, Sean, we have Suzanne, live at the Magic Castle. It's nice to see this. So much stuff that's come out recently has been single-trick DVDs, and you get to see one performance. It's nice to get an old-style, L&L-style DVD, where you get to sit down and watch like a half-an-hour show.
It's brilliant. You get the show at the castle, and then she explains the tricks afterwards.
She does, and she has a sit-down interview where she goes through a whole bunch of stuff as well. Look, I've never seen Suzanne perform before. I've never seen her. And I got to tell you, I think that the best analogy I can use in terms of her personality and her performing persona is she's kind of like the Ellen DeGeneres of the magic world.
She is.
She comes out, and the very second she steps on stage, she's like, hey, how you doing? Take these cards. Give them a shuffle. You're captivated from the very first second.
She's very charismatic. Like we've said, we've not seen many female magicians, especially in Britain, that come out with so much charisma and pizzazz.
Yeah,
and,
you know,
and
what?
Hit them all.
There's a lot of DVDs, and they come in, and it's like a half an hour show. And at the end, I'm just like, oh, kill me now. This is just dreadful, boring as hell. Suzanne, all the way through, I was just captivated and interested. Even when she started on with the cups and balls, which generally I hate, she just captivated me all the way through. Let's talk about the show first of all.
Well, the way she's got a really awkward guy helping her. She deals with him. She's obviously
really
been out
well.
On work this night after night after night. She deals with him, and so that's a pleasure to watch her doing that.
Yeah, absolutely.
So the tricks on the routines that she teaches.
The first things that she does is a blank deck trick.
Well, let's play together. It's called.
Yeah.
Then we've got coming home.
Yeah.
Followed by a mother's love. And then the journey. So
okay.
let's talk about Let's Play Together.
Let's Play Together. It's a blank deck routine, basically. If you've mm-hmm. seen Greg Wilson's blank deck ambitious card, which ends in an anniversary waltz, it's very similar to that. She's injected her own personality into it. But what's great about it is you've got a kicker ending at the end when the entire deck becomes printed front and back.
Mm-hmm.
So well constructed, it really is. Then you've got Coming Home. If you've never used, if you've never used the Greg Wilson-style blank deck routine,
mm-hmm.
it's just brilliant. It really is. I mean, I use it all the time. And I'm going to go down this route because I think that what she's done,
yeah.
it, she's made it even clearer.
So Coming Home, which is the card-to-pocket routine.
With a deck-to-pocket finale.
Yeah, the classic deck-to-pocket finale.
Yeah.
And Mother's Love, which is a plaster trick. So it's the transposition.
This is brilliant.
You explain it because you liked it.
I really liked it. This is, you take a couple of different coloured plasters. One, the guy puts his initials on,
mm-hmm.
and you put that onto his hand or his arm. So he's got a plaster, and on the other side, it's got his initials. Then the other one, you put something else on. In her presentation, it's a heart. She sticks that to her.
Mm-hmm.
And then
on their forehead.
On her forehead. And then they change places. So
they
hers
do.
Has now got the initial on different coloured plasters, and the stuff that's wrote on there changes places.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was a great transposition. Her presentation for it, I wasn't too keen on. It worked for her because it talked about mothers, and she's a mother, and so she could bring that into it. Wouldn't work for me, obviously, but I did like the actual routine. I think you put your own presentation.
How would you suggest getting the plaster in?
It's not sexist.
You say something sexist, then knock you out. You need the plaster for it. So then we moved on to the journey, which was basically it's her standing ovation cups and balls routine. And like she said, she performs at the castle a lot, and this is her go-to effect that gets her the standing ovation
you
at the end
why.
Of the show.
You can see why.
It's good. It's
at
got all the
end,
kickers.
The finale, when all of the jewels and everything come out, it's just absolutely brilliant. It's a well-constructed, beautifully performed, technically flawless cups and balls.
It is. It's a two-disc set, and it's not just got, it's got the interviews on there as well, because she talks in depth about the routine and about how she got into magic as well. I mean, it's interesting to listen to.
Yeah. You know, it's nice to have a role model for the female performers out there, because there's so many guys, there's so many men that the guys look up to. It's nice to have a lady that's awesome, that's like real.
She's just a good magician. You don't need to do the lady thing. She's a good magician.
Hang on.
Frank.
You are the one. Off camera, did you or did you not say that Suzanne is better than any female magician in the UK?
Yes, she's better. I was complimenting her, not being patronising.
No, what you're doing is you're dissing all the female magicians in the UK. You're saying everybody in the UK that's female sucks and she doesn't.
Yeah, I mean,
Yes. There we go. Enough said. I'm giving it 95%. I think it's absolutely brilliant. Any other day, it'd be Worker of the Week. It's just that social's better.
You're only giving it that high to get out.
He hates women.
It's not worth 95%. You're giving 95% to try and dig yourself out of some little magic.
You're the one that hates all the female magicians in the UK, not me.
Well, there's out of hours reasons for that. Now, we're not going there.
You've already been there.
Right.
Just give it a mark and we'll move on.
72%. It's good. It's good. It's 72%.
That's so harsh. 72.
You can't say women are good at palming balls. You said that.
You can't. You've dissed every
only
single
72.
Woman. Yeah, that's really harsh.
What do you mean only 72?
It's a double DVD set. It's really strong magic. People can learn from it. She's
I know,
a
but
strong
is it
performer.
Stuff I'm gonna,
it's stuff. Would you do the blank deck trick? Yes or no? Is it a worker?
It's definitely a worker.
So would you do it? Yes or
yes.
No? Yes. The card to pocket. Is it a worker?
I can't go up to 90%.
Is it a per?
I can't go up to 90%.
No, no, I didn't ask anything
80%,
else.
80%, all right, 80%. You've persuaded
wait,
me.
No,
I'm
getting you up to 90. Is it
I'm
a
not,
worker?
I'm
is it a worker? Yes or no?
I'm not getting any higher.
Is it a worker?
They're all workers.
They're all workers. Every single one. So it's a worker. It's brilliant. Did you like the interview?
I'm bored now. 80%. I'm giving it 80%.
Okay, so before we go into the final review, it's App of the Month.
Yay.
He hates apps. He hates them. Anybody who knows the show knows I love apps. So just listen to me and not Sean. This is a new one. Actually, it's a re-release.
Okay.
By Angelo. Angelo Carbone.
Excellent.
You like Angelo.
Creative-minded magic. There I love him. Go. Yeah.
Now, I'll tell you when this is perfect.
Yeah.
This is perfect when you're out and about performing.
Yeah.
Do you ever get this? Oh, do you know Dynamo?
Yeah.
Come on, you get that all the time.
Yeah.
You can then go, actually, I do. Would you like to see him do a trick?
Okay.
Yeah, that's your comeback now.
That's your in. That's the answer.
So
right, okay.
I'm going to show you. I've got his phone number. I can't show them on camera, obviously, because... but I'm going to text him. So if we can get off the sticks and have a look really close, I'm going to text him. There he is, Dynamo. There we go. All right, so we're going to text him.
What have you been talking about?
What I want you to do, not much really. I've been on the internet too much. But think of a colour.
I'm thinking of a colour.
Very good.
Yeah.
And think of a playing card.
Got one.
Okay, come look at this. I'm going to say, hey, D, because that's what I call him D. He calls me C. I'm...
For Craig. For Craig.
Obviously.
For Craig.
For Craig. For Craig. I'm with John. What's his colour? Oh, sorry. Colour.
Colour's not got a Y in it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Colour and card.
Mm-hmm.
Question mark, because grammar's important.
Yeah. And then what?
Well, now we wait, because like he could be on a shoot or anything.
He could be doing anything. So speaking of Dynamo, you know, I was the official Budweiser
magician.
Actually,
before you tell me, everyone needs to know the colour and the card. What's the colour?
Black and the Six of Clubs.
Black and the Six of Clubs, okay, carry
no,
on.
No, I was the official Budweiser magician years ago, and then when Dynamo
that is true as well, isn't it?
When Dynamo shut up, he then got that, right? Then years
you're,
later...
You're quite bitter about that, aren't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, years later, he got the Pepsi gig, didn't he?
Mm.
Yeah? Well, and have you seen it? His face isn't on Pepsi anymore. You know why, don't you?
Why?
I got it. See?
Hey, that's brilliant. Congratulations, Sean.
They came out 2 weeks ago.
Contract. That's awesome.
Yeah, so I'm now the official Pepsi magician. Yeah.
That's brilliant. That's awesome. Mm. Good stuff.
So what happens with this anyway?
Well, hopefully he'll text. He could be
busy.
He could be busy. I mean, come on. Yeah. Oh, hang on. Dave
you've
made
got,
me put it on
you've
silent.
You've got a text message.
Well, it should have made the sound, but Dave gave me put it
I'm
on silent.
I'm going to read it.
Yeah, read it. What read it out loud.
Let's hold it so the camera can see. It says, hi, C.
It says Craig, but...
Craig, yeah. Hope all is well. I've been thinking hard about what...
Sounds like Dynamo, doesn't it?
Thinking hard about what your friend is thinking of, and I'm getting the impression that the C...
Oh, unlock it.
Yeah.
8073.
Hang on. That the chosen colour was black,
which is what I said. You did say that.
And the card was the Six of Clubs. Let me know if I'm right.
Yeah, I better tell him you're the man. That's awesome.
You that's know. Right. So that's good. It worked.
Yeah, you the
and you're texting him back now.
Man. Yeah, I'm just texting him back.
Excellent.
He is the man.
So anyway, it's app of the month. It works.
So that's what it is. Yeah. Basically, you can. There's lots of settings in there. You can have the text come through from anybody, mm-hmm. not just Dynamo, from anyone. You can also, during the context of the routine, you, as long as you've found out the person's name you're performing for earlier on, you can have it so that the text is sent back addressed to the person that you're performing it on. There's lots of different ideas in there, but the main concept behind it is it allows you, apparently, to have somebody via text read the mind of a spectator. It's a very simple routine to do. There's a small bit of memory work that takes like 5 minutes and that's it.
Perfect.
It's good, isn't it?
It's good. What are you going to give it?
No, it's app of the month, mate. We don't
it's
give it.
App of the month. Oh, we don't do it. Well, I don't know. I've never done
it. It's just got the award of
it's
app of the
good.
Month.
App of the month. There we go. App of the month. What's it called?
You love it, don't you? If you want to download it, it's available on Apple. I'm not too sure about Android because I'd never have an Android phone in a million years. But it's called...
What's it called? You have to tell them what it's called. You can't just go, here's an app.
Magic SMS 2.
Magic SMS 2.
Because the first one came out, this is the relaunch. Magic SMS 2.
App of the month.
Oh, no, please go ahead.
Thanks.
Do it.
So next up, we've got Spontaneous Combustion, which is an effect by Granell. He doesn't seem to have a surname, but he looks like quite a tough guy. I wouldn't mess with him.
Yeah, no, you definitely wouldn't.
So this is good.
I know you're very excited about performing this, aren't you?
Yeah. Right.
Get off the sticks.
He's done it already. I think
you should know after 3 years.
I have conversations before we start, so David knows when it needs to come off the sticks.
Yeah. Oh, really?
I just don't think halfway through it needs to come off the sticks. Now,
I can't multitask.
Don't go there. Right. Right. So, Craig, what you're going to do is you're going to pick one of these lovely cards for me. So just touch the back of a card or take one out.
I'll go for that one, mate. Oh, I've got two. Sorry.
Brilliant. And show the camera.
Got it. I haven't seen it myself yet.
Right. Now, the performance, what you'd actually do is you have to get them to sign their name onto the playing card. Their card's going to go somewhere into the middle of the deck. That'll do. Like this.
Okay.
And you're going to show them that it's not obviously at the top of the pack. It's not at the bottom of the pack. And then you're going to try and find their card. So watch close.
Are you going to get all the patter about heating up and... That's the best bit.
Yeah, no, but we've not got the smoke, have we? Because he does smoking, and we've not smoking inside, are we?
Should have had a vapor.
But if you have a look, watch close. If I squeeze the deck real hard, I don't know if you can get this on the camera, but if I squeeze hard, the deck starts to heat up when my fingers heat up. If you watch real close, you should actually see my fingers. And if you see that start to happen, actually start to melt, you should see it slowly start to melt right through the pack, all the way down. If you can see that, right the way through, till they get to just one card. The Three of Spades.
That's the one.
And that was the card that you picked.
It was indeed. Now, normally, we talk a little bit off camera about what we think about products. Mm-hmm. We didn't do that with this.
We didn't.
I have no idea what you think about it, and I'm actually very curious to find out.
Well, I looked in the mirror, and I've only spent 5 minutes doing this. That's all
the
time
I had
to do it.
You should be spending half an hour before.
Yes, I know. I like it. When you've got the handling down properly, in the mirror, I don't know how it looked on the camera there, but you can actually see the fingers going down.
Here's a question for you. You like it.
Yeah.
Would you actually carry that around with you?
I think it's something that if you've got some teenage kids and you want to do a Dynamo moment, it's more than yourself. Here's pick a card. Here it is in my wallet. If you want to do something, I think it ticks that box.
But there's a million of other Dynamo moments. The card coming to the top of the deck, if you've never seen it before, is a Dynamo moment. A card appearing in a wallet is a Dynamo moment. A card folded up under a spectator's watch is a Dynamo moment. Anything can be a Dynamo moment.
However, I know what we all think about the ambitious card and stuff as magicians. However, what sounds better, a card went in the middle of a pack and it jumped up to the top, or the magician's fingers melted, and I could see them melt all the way through the cards until they hit one card. It melted all the way down into the middle and found my card. That sounds better. It does sound better.
It's quite angly, isn't it?
It is pretty angly, but it works.
It's quite angly. You've got to really consider your angles.
Mm.
You can do one trick with it and one trick only, and that's it.
But it's like you were saying, if you're using any sort of gaff deck, you could switch in it. You could switch in if you wanted.
Would you really want to do that?
What
would you rather carry around with you? Because you want to switch it in from this pocket.
I mean,
right?
I'm not saying it's brilliant. I'm saying it works.
I would rather turn a deck of cards at the end of a routine into a see-through crystal deck.
However, so would 10 magicians in Northampton, 10 magicians in Leicester, 10 magicians in... So this is, every magician's got an Omni deck, right? And they're all doing it. If you've been to a wedding and you've seen a magician, you've probably seen an Omni deck, some sponge balls, the signed card routine. You've probably not seen that.
For good reason.
Why good reason? You're not liking it?
It's not great. No, if I was going to do something like that, I'd rather do...
It's a long video and the guy does it.
It's big. I might not have done it well.
I'd rather do the Sankey thing where the coin... drops down through the deck and
the Sankey thing.
I'd rather have the coin drop down visibly and hit the card. If I was going to carry a gaff deck around to do something like that, I'd rather do that. That reminds me a little bit of a pull. I want to say it was Paul Gertner. I don't know where he had a card picked, had it put back in the deck, and he went up and he bit the cards. And there was a bite mark in the card.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
And then
you
bit it down to one card and it was their card.
Mm-hmm.
And I bought that and tried it for a little bit and I just couldn't get to grips with it. I think it'd be the same with that, to be honest. It's okay. It's not bad. And I imagine that moment would go really, really well. But the angle considerations, got to carry around a special deck just to do that.
It's not brilliant, but it does work. It does work. If somebody bought it because they like the trailer, it works.
Yeah, it does work, but there's only so much crap you can carry around with you.
What are you going to give it?
I would give it 60%.
Yeah, 65% for spontaneous combustion.
Hang on, we've got so many radically different viewpoints here, and you're only giving it 5% more than me.
I'm saying it works. You can't say it doesn't work. You buy it, it works.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. So why are you only giving it 65%?
It's not going in my set.
Yeah.
It works. It might go in your set.
It's not going in my set. It's never going to go in my set.
Well, that's why you're giving it the same as me. It does work. You can't say it doesn't work. If somebody wanted to do that trick, it works. You can't say it doesn't.
65%.
Yeah.
Right, guys, that's it on the Wizard... that's it on the Wizard Product Review this week. So we've got Suzanne, which was absolutely awesome.
Yeah.
We've got Profiles, free with the social deck, which was brilliant. We both agree that's brilliant. And then we've got this, which is
spontaneous
combustion, and obviously the app of the month. Guys, thank you very much this week for watching us. You can follow us on all the usual places. Magic Cafe, Office of Advisement. You can follow us on Facebook, facebook.com/worldmagicshop. You can follow me on Twitter at slightly unusual, and apparently you aren't on Twitter, but you can follow you on Facebook.
facebook.com/alternativemagician. I'm Sean.
I'm Craig.
That's Blammo.